was in a math class, and I was not that good at this math class. And the teacher said, are you going to use this in your practical life? I said, no. And she said, then go and take an art class or something. And I went, I can't do that, I'm an artist. I've been drawing all my life. I've been working on art all my life. I went to that first art teacher, and she said, yes, you can absolutely come into my class. And at 18 years old, I finally called myself an artist for the first time. I finally acknowledged my creativity for the first time. And I started on the path of acknowledging my story and adopting what was uniquely mine into that story. And listening to that little voice that I had when I was very young that said, follow your instincts, trust yourself, hone your craft, find what's uniquely yours. This is literally my PayPal in college. I was an art major for 1.5 semesters. Because I found that I was way too much of a firstborn, Capricorn, organized child to be a starving artist. I was petrified of being a starving artist. I knew the value of creativity, but I was scared. And so I didn't lean into that for my future career. I went into a different major that was based in education and health and communication for public health entities, and it brought me full circle to creativity, so it's okay. This palette is like a sin to any real artist because it's a mess. Usually any real watercolors would chip all that little paint out and put fresh paint down and leave it really, really clean. A really good watercolor keeps their palette very clean, the brushes very clean. And I'm very meticulous about that, but I love this messy, messy palette. And I intentionally add to it to create history. I have a clean one too, but I still use this palette. I put this up here because when I went into my first job in corporate marketing, I worked for a pharmaceutical research company. And I was in my early 20s, and I was responsible for the corporate brand to big pharma companies and for supervising the brand to our consumers for 43 research sites. So I had this huge job. Every single day I helped inform decisions made by a multi-million dollar business development team that was doing huge deals every day. I reported to a vice president who was also in charge of business development and marketing. And so that meant I was really in charge of marketing. And I had access to a C-suite all the time. And over time, this group of people said, you should go get an MBA, and you should, and they tried to, in a nice way, and for a good reason, put me into this system, and I found that I was actually getting kind of sick. I was not feeling well when I would go to work. I felt really scared that this creative heart I had developed was going to sort of die because I was an old one. But I didn't feel like I had a choice. And eventually, I left that job when I went over to the brand marketing side, and I realized that even as a marketing person and a brand person, we were telling the stories of companies, and we were telling the stories of brand. We were not telling the stories of individuals. So when I work with people now, I really encourage them to start with their individual story. Start with the leadership of where they begin, then add that to their teams, then add those teams to the organization, and then inform the consumer message. Our biggest consumer audiences today are women, millennials, and Gen Z. And those people care about connection and relevance.